Hello my dear students, welcome back to Prudence Coaching Mathematics class. Here we will discuss algebraic expression. We will know what is algebraic expression with example. We will know about coefficient, variable, constant. Again, we will know about the types of algebraic expression, that is monomial, binomial and polynomial. And we are going to know about algebraic expression and numeral expression. Students, we will know about like terms, unlike terms. So we are going to learn many things in this particular video. So watch the video till end. Let's start with the definition or meaning of algebraic expression. What is an algebraic expression? Algebraic expression is a combination, means it will consist of constants, variable and algebraic operation. Algebraic operation means plus, minus, into and division. All these things are algebraic operation, because here we use all these things for the calculation. And here constants, do you know what is the meaning of constants? Constants means the value which are fixed. As you can see, 6 here. 6 is fixed, you cannot change it. Therefore, it is constant. And what is a variable? Variable means this x here. Because here x can take any value. So here the value of x is not fixed. It will vary according to the situation. Therefore, it is the variable. And students, you must know that this algebraic expression is made up of terms. What are these terms? It may consist of one term, two term, or many terms. So here, as you can see, we have been separated this equation into three parts. Okay, how this separation is being done? By the algebraic expression negative sign and the positive sign. These two sign, wherever you will find, that sign is separating the equation into different parts. These separated parts are known as terms. So here, as you can see, here we have one term before the negative sign, another term is here and another term is here. Okay, so here we have total three terms, because we have two sign of negative and positive. So it may be also like this, that is 2x square plus 7x plus 6. Here also we will have 1, 2, 3 terms. For example, if we take 2y plus 7, here we have two terms. Before plus we have 1, after plus we have 1. So these are the terms. My dear students, we will learn more about these terms when we will learn about the types of algebraic expressions. Now let us move on to the next slide and see, is 25 an algebraic expression? What is your opinion? Do you think 25, which is a constant, is an algebraic expression? No, it is not an algebraic expression. Why? Because to be an algebraic expression, an expression should have at least one variable. As we can find that with 25 we don't have any variable, therefore it is not an algebraic expression. And one operation to be algebraic, here we don't have any operation. Operation means multiplication, plus, division or subtraction. We don't have any of this four with 25, therefore it is not an algebraic expression. My dear students, instead of 25, if I would take 25x, so what is your opinion? Is it an algebraic expression or not? Students, as you can see, it has at least one variable. Here variable is x. Students, you may say that, ma'am, it does not have any operation. Operation means I have said plus, minus, multiplication or division. So here we don't have any sign. Is it so? It has a sign or operation here, because whenever after any constant, here we have 25, if we had any other number and after that if we have any variable, instead of x if we had y, y square, anything, any variable, then you will always remember that if a constant is there and after that if we have a variable, then between 25 or the constant, that is 25, and the variable here x, we have a multiplication sign. So here we have a operation. Therefore 25x is an algebraic expression, but 25 is not an algebraic expression. I think it is clear to you now. Now let us move on to the next one. Here in details we will learn about variable, coefficient of the variable and constant value with an example, that is 2x plus 6. Students, here x is a variable. I have already discussed about variable. Here, as you can see, variable means whose value is unknown or not fixed, which can vary, is variable. So here we have written x is a variable whose value is not known, means unknown to us. We don't know the actual value of x, which can take any value. We can write any value instead of x. So it will vary according to the situation. Therefore, it is the variable here. Next. Now we will know about the coefficient of the variable. Here the variable is x, therefore we have written coefficient of x. What is this coefficient? Students, let me explain it to you. Students, in between this 2 and x, we have a multiplication sign. So whenever you will find the multiplication sign in between a variable and a constant, then the constant which is there before the variable is your coefficient of that particular variable. Therefore, 2 is the coefficient of x. If I take another one example, that is x by 2, can you say what is the coefficient of x in this particular term? Take your time. You just think. Okay, now I am explaining it to you, students. Here, this 2 which I have written in the denominator, that is x divided by 2, we can write it as half into x. Can we write it like this? So here in between this constant and this x, we have multiplication sign. So we can say that half is the coefficient of x here. Now I think it is clear to you what is the meaning of coefficient of any variable. Now we will know about constant value, which we have already learned. So here we have a term that is plus 6. Okay, so with 6 we don't have any variable. Do we have any variable with 6? No, we don't have any variable. And 6, which is a definite value, or it will never change, therefore it is a constant value. So here the value which is not going to change, that is the constant. Students, now let us know the types of algebraic expressions, which are very important. So students, concentrate and listen very carefully, that the types of algebraic expression or algebraic expression is classified into three main types. What are the three types? First is monomial, next is binomial, and thirdly polynomial. Do you know the meaning of the word mono? Mono means one. Bi means two, and poly means many. Students, therefore, monomial means a expression which will have only one term. Okay, as you can see here, we have only one term. Next is binomial, means it will have two terms. As you can see here, we have a positive sign. Okay, and before positive sign, as we know that plus and minus separates the expression into terms. Therefore, we have two terms here, that is 6x1 and 7y1. So this is binomial, and you must remember, you cannot write it like this, that is 6x plus 6x. If we write two same terms and if we give the sign plus in between them, then it is not a binomial term. To be a binomial term, the terms must be different. As you can see, first one is 6x and second one is 7y. So here, as you can see, here we have three terms. Therefore, we can call it as trinomial, because tri means three. For example, tricycle, which has three wheel, bicycle, which has two wheels. So here, bi means two, tri means three, mono means one. So here, as trinomial is written, as you can see, we have three terms, that is 1, 2, and 3. So here we have three terms. And polynomial, what is this polynomial? Polynomial means the expression which can consist any number of terms, but it must be more than one. means it will start from two terms. Okay, those terms are polynomial, and you must remember that the variable which is there in the polynomial, for example, if we take this one, if we write or change this one as 6x square and 7y cube, then this will be a polynomial. Why? Because the variable is having the exponent, that is 2 and 3, which are integers and non-negative integers. Don't worry, students. If you have any confusion in your mind, I will not let that confusion be in your mind. I will clearly explain all the things in details. Students, as you can see, here we will explain the types of algebraic expressions in detail. First, we will start with monomial. What is a monomial? Here, an algebraic expression having only one term, as I have explained. For example, let us clear our doubts with help of example. Here we have 4x square. As you can see, within 4x square, we have operation, that is multiplication between 4 and x square, but we don't have any addition and subtraction to separate the terms. Therefore, it is only a single term. Therefore, this is monomial. Next example is 8xy. So 8xy, we can write it as 8 into x into y. So here operation, that is multiplication. Here multiplication is the operation or the only operation. We don't have any plus or minus. Therefore, it is only a single term. 83x, that is 83 into x. This is also a monomial. And 9y, this is also a monomial because 9 into y. Only multiplication operation is used here. Now, let us learn about binomial. Binomial expression is an algebraic expression which is having two terms. So, as I have said, that binomial expression will have two terms. And you must remember that those terms must to be unlike. For example, we have taken 5xy plus 8. Here we have a addition in between the two terms, that is 5xy and 8. So here the two terms are 5xy and another one term is 8. And as you can see, these two terms are different. Therefore, it is a binomial expression. Again, you can see in the next example, we have xyz, which is a term, and another term is x cube. And this x cube and xyz are two separate terms or unlike terms. Therefore, as we have two terms, that is 1 and this one is 2, and we have unlike terms, therefore this is a binomial expression. Now let us see the next one. In general expression, with more than one term, so the number of terms must be more than one, with non-negative integral exponent. So here the variable will be there, and the power of variable should not be a negative, and it must be any positive integer. For example, here we have the polynomial AXBYCA. Here we have 1, 2, 3 terms. Therefore, it is more than one terms, and the variable here is in the first term x, in the second term y, in the third term we have no variable, that is here we have CA, which are constant here. And here, the power of x is 1 and the power of y is 1. So here, these two powers are not negative and those are integer. Therefore, it is a polynomial. But if we take an expression like this, that is x to the power minus 2 plus 2. Here, the variable x is having a power that is minus 2, which is a negative. Therefore, it is not a polynomial. Now, as you can see, next one, that is y cube. Here, 3 is the exponent and it is positive. Therefore, this one is 1 term, this one is 2 and this one is 3, which is more than 1 term. So here total 3 terms are there. Therefore, this is a polynomial with 3 terms, that is trinomial. Now let us know other types of expression which are not algebraic expression, or you can say only expression which may be algebraic, may not be. Okay, first we will know about numeric expression. Numeric expression means what? A expression which will consist of operation. Operation means positive sign, negative sign, division and multiplication sign, and consist of numbers only, means no variable will be there. Okay, never include any variable. For example, 10 minus 2. Here 10 is also a constant, 2 is also a constant. In between them we have a negative, that is a minus sign, which is an operation. Therefore, it is a numeric expression. 15 divided by 3. Here we have 15, which is a constant. 3 is also a constant, which are numbers. In between these numbers, we have a operation, that is division. So this is a numeric expression. I think now it is clear to you that numeric expression means it will consist of numbers and operations and no variables will be there. Now, variable expression means what? Which will contain variables along with the numbers and operation. That means variables will also be there with numbers and operation. Those are variable expression. As you can see, 2x plus 6y. Here 2x. See, we have 2, which is a number. X is a variable. We have 6, which is a number. Y is a variable, and in between those we have plus, that is positive sign, so which is an operation. So here we have variable, numbers and operation, therefore it is a variable expression. Next one also you can see, this is number, this is variable, this is variable, this is operation, this is number, this is number, therefore it is also variable expression, as it consists of variable, number and operation. We will start with the most important part of this video, how you are going to recognize any like term and any unlike term. First, we will know about like term. Like terms means what? The terms that contain the same variable which is raised to the same power. And you must remember, only numerical coefficient may vary. For example, we have 5y plus 7y. Here, two terms are 5y, another term is 7y. So here, the variable is y in the both terms, and the value or the power of this variable is y to the power 1. So here both the variable are same and both the powers of the variable are same. Okay, so this is the first condition, and you know that the coefficient of x here is 5 and coefficient of y here is 7. So in the first term, that is the coefficient of y is 5. In the next term, coefficient of y is 7. So coefficient may vary, that is, it may be anything. Coefficient may be anything, but the variable must be same and the power of the variable must be same, that is like terms. Now let us know about unlike terms. Unlike terms means what? Which does not have the same literal coefficient and cannot be raised to the same power. For example, as you can see, here we have the variable x here in the first term, and in the second term we have the variable y. So as the variable are different, therefore it is not a like term, it is an unlike term. And students, as you can see here, the power is 1 in both the case, but as the variable are different, therefore it is unlike terms. Means those terms which are not like are unlike, because here you can see that two different variable x and y and not raised to the same powers. So here we will learn to differentiate the like and unlike terms with help of example. First one, we have 2x plus 19x. So here both the variable are same and the power is 1 in both the case, and we have the different coefficient 2 and 19, and so it is a like terms. Okay, next one, 2x plus 19a. Here the variable are different, one is x, another is a, therefore it is not a like term, it is an unlike term. See, the variable are different, therefore it is unlike term. Next one, we have 4w minus 10w. So here both the case we have the variable, that is w, and the coefficient are different, so this is like term. But in the second term we have 4w minus 10w square. Here the variable are same, but the power here is 2 and power here is 1. So as the exponents are different, so this is unlike term. Next one, as you can see, 14.2 into r minus 12r. So here both the case we have the variable r, and before r we have 14.2, and second one before r we have minus 12. So coefficient may be different, so this is a like term. But next one, we have 12r and 12s. Here you can see, here first variable is r, second one is s. As the variable are different, therefore it is a like term. Let us see 32a square plus 9a square. In both the case we have, or in both the terms we have the variable a. First one is having the power 2 or exponent is 2, and second one is also exponent is 2. Therefore, as it has the same variable and same exponent, therefore it is a like terms. Now next one is 32a square, that is 32a square plus 9a cube. Here, as you can see, the variable are same, but the exponent are different. Therefore, it is not a like term, it is an unlike term because the exponents are different here. Next one, as you can see, we have 8y plus 5y. So here the variable are same and the power of y is 1 in both the case, therefore it is a like term. Next one is 8y plus 5. First one, we have a variable y. Here we don't have a variable y, or you can say we have the variable y to the power 0, because a to the power 0, that is any variable to the power 0, is always 1. So in place of 5 into 1, we can write here y to the power 0. So here the variable is same, but the power here is 1 and here we have 0. Therefore this one is unlike term. So thus we can say the terms having identical variables, means same variables raised to the same exponent, that is the power of the variable should be also same. In that case it will be like terms. So students, with this we come to the end of this particular video. If you find the content of this video helpful, then like, share, subscribe this channel. Also click on the bell icon to get regular update of this particular channel. Students, if you want to get tuitions or communicate with the expert faculties of this particular channel, you must join our Telegram channel, or you can comment below. Students, have a nice day, stay safe and keep learning with fun.